Hello and welcome to the East Telford Benefice online Mothering Sunday service. It's great to have you with us. I do hope that you're in fine voice and we'll join in with some of our hymns. And we're going to start now with Now Thank We All Our God. And so let's begin our service. We pray in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Praise God who loves us. Praise God who cares. We look at our world in spring and we praise you, God, for signs of new life. We look at those who love us. And we praise you, God, for friends and family. We look at our church family around us, and we praise you, God, that you are with us in prayers and readings, in thoughts and words, in bread and wine, in actions and laughter and song. Bless this day as we share it with you. Amen. We know human beings don't always treat each other as God's precious children. We need God's help to leave our mistakes and failures behind and to grow into the people that we really want to be. So now we come to God as one from whom no secrets are hidden to ask for his forgiveness and peace. When we fail to acknowledge your love that gives us life, Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. When you call us to be unselfish, but we seek our own way, Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. When we ignore others who need help, Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. The Lord is loving and forgiving to all who turn to him. Tender and compassionate as a mother towards her children, So may the God of love bring us back to himself, forgive us our sins, and assure us of his eternal love. In Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We pray now the collect for Mothering Sunday. Let us pray. God of compassion, whose Son Jesus Christ, the child of Mary, shared the life of a home in Nazareth, and on the cross drew the whole human family to himself, strengthen us in our daily living, that in joy and in sorrow we may know the power of your presence to bind together and to heal. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. We now have our first two readings.
This reading is taken from Exodus chapter 2, verses 1 to 10. Now a man from the house of Levi went and married a Levite woman. The woman conceived and bore a son, and when she saw that he was a fine baby, she hid him 3 months. When she could hide him no longer, she got a papyrus basket for him and plastered it with bitumen and pitch. She put the child in it and placed it among the reeds on the bank of the river. His sister stood at a distance to see what would happen to him. The daughter of the Pharaoh came down to bathe at the river. While her attendants walked beside the river, she saw the basket among the reeds and sent her maid to bring it. When she opened it, she saw the child. He was crying, and she took pity on him. "This must be one of the Hebrew's children," she said. Then his sister said to the Pharaoh's daughter, "Shall I go get you a nurse from the Hebrew women to nurse the child for you?" Pharaoh's daughter said to her, "Yes." So the girl went and called the child's mother. Pharaoh's daughter said to her, "Take this child and nurse it for me. I will give you your wages." So the woman took the child and nursed it. When the child grew up, she brought him to the Pharaoh's daughter, and she took him as her son. She named him Moses, because, she said, "I drew him out of the water." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. This reading is taken from Colossians chapter 3, verses 12 to 17. As God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, meekness, and patience. Bear with one another, and if anyone has a complaint against the other, forgive each other, just as the Lord has forgiven you. So you also must forgive. Above all, clothe yourselves with love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony. And let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, to which indeed you are called in one body, and be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly, teach and admonish one another in all wisdom, and with gratitude in your hearts, sing psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs to God. And whatever you do, in word or deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Before we hand over to Gareth for our gospel reading, we're going to have a hymn and sing Love Divine or Love's Excelling.
Thank you. Hear the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to St John. Glory to you, O Lord. Meanwhile, standing near the cross of Jesus were his mother and his mother's sister, Mary, the wife of Clopas, and Mary Magdalene. When Jesus saw his mother and the disciple whom he loved standing beside her, he said to his mother, "Woman, here is your son." Then he said to the disciple, "Here is your mother." And from that hour the disciple took her into his own home. This is the Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ.
Now I have the pleasure of handing over to Kerry Debenham for our sermon for today.
May I speak this day in the name of the living Lord, who is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. So today is Mothering Sunday, a day for when Christians use the occasion to think about things which concern motherhood, to give thanks for the Church as a mother, of the Virgin Mary as the mother of Jesus, and to remember that God cares for us like a mother. And we think of those who have been a mother to us. In the reading today from Exodus, we heard about the birth of Moses and of his mother and how she put him in a basket on the river in an attempt to save him. We didn't hear about the midwives who stood up to Pharaoh, those midwives, Shipra and Puah, who had been instructed to kill the male babies at birth. These two women earned their place in history because they displayed great courage and disobeyed the order, because they knew what they were being asked to do was wrong. I am often amazed by people like this, people who are prepared to put themselves in danger because they are true to what they believe. And this also was the daughter of Pharaoh, because she rescued Moses. Contrary to the plans that Pharaoh had, Moses was safely delivered by the work of more women on that bankside that day. There was the sister of Moses who followed the basket down the river, watching for his safety. His sister spoke to the Pharaoh's daughter and suggested she get a mother from the Hebrew women. And there she brought her own mother, Moses' mother, to her. It is quite powerful in this story that the Pharaoh's daughter was prepared to defy the power of her father to do what she believed to be right. She knew where the baby had come from. She knew he was a child of the Hebrews, but she still did what was right. We don't know if she was a mother herself, but she certainly showed the love of a true mother who looked evil in the face and wouldn't allow that child to be killed by it. This story shows us that even when events may seem chaotic and out of control, God is still at work, even in these most unpredictable circumstances. Today, as we celebrate all that is good about mothers or grandparents, siblings or relatives, or even those not connected through family ties, we think of those qualities of protection, nurture, and self-giving love. Our Colossians reading talks about clothing ourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, meekness, patience, and above all, love. Now, it is not just mothers who are called to have this type of clothing. We all are. And if we were to clothe ourselves as directed, we would have all we need to model Christ, to be that loving force of good which can stand up to the evil and wickedness in the world. Our gospel reading tells us of when Jesus, a grown man in his 30s, is about to die. We see his mother Mary choosing to watch her son's suffering rather than to leave him. We see that she waits with her women friends all the long hours while Jesus suffered on the cross. Yet Jesus displayed his love for her, even in his suffering. He is thinking of how she will be when he is gone, and he gives her over into the care of his disciple John. We see all the love and compassion he had for his mother, and his sense of responsibility for her happiness and well-being. Love, compassion, and kindness, all qualities which are being displayed by many today in the face of what is happening around the world. I think of those on the Eastern European continent who are currently prepared to stand up against the power of President Putin. I think of the men who stay behind in Ukraine to defend their homes, disregarding the danger for which they place themselves in. And I think too of those other war-torn countries where daily acts of aggression and oppression is the real life experience of many. It is this love, compassion, and kindness which is shining through in the people who are sending aid, those people who are raising money to help, those people who are opening their homes to those in need. All of these acts take extraordinary strength. And there is real strength in the women, the mothers, the grandmothers, the sisters who leave with those children to protect them, often taking dangerous routes to safety, all the time hoping that one day they will be able to return, while praying that their loved ones who stayed behind remain safe. These strong women stand against the authority and the power of men. The self-sacrificial love of the women shows real courage and strength, both in the stand which the women are in our reading take and in the stand of the women fleeing war today. These women are an example to us all, but we are need to be reminded that all of these qualities we talk of are divine. It is God who gave birth to all creation, God who loves everything he has made, and God who in Jesus will give everything to protect and save. So as we celebrate our mothers and think of those strong women in the Bible who cared for the children, let us think about those mothers and sisters who are far from home, cut off from family because of war and oppression, and give thanks for what we have been blessed with, and pray always for an end to the atrocities which are happening across this world today. So let us pray. Lord Jesus, you know well the blessing an earthly home can receive. Have our thanks for all the love we have received in our homes, especially for those who have nurtured us from our earliest years. Hear our prayers for mothers everywhere, that they may never lose heart, especially when their lives are upturned to war and oppression, especially when they are far from home. Amen.
Thank you, Kerry, for those inspiring words. We're now going to affirm our faith with the words of the Creed. We believe in God the Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth is named. We believe in God the Son, who lives in our hearts through faith and fills us with his love. We believe in God, the Holy Spirit, who strengthens us with power from on high. We believe in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. So I hand over now to Reverend Debbie for our intercessions.
And so let us pray. Loving God, our Heavenly Father, in our worship today, we say thank you for all that our mothers are to us, for all that our Mother Church is for us, and for all that both do for us. But we also know that today is difficult for some people, people holding hurt and grief and perhaps anger. We pray that you will draw alongside those who are hurting today to comfort them and surround them with your tender care. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray today for women who grieve because they've been unable to have the children they so long to hold and love. We pray for mothers who grieve because, like Mary, they have had to see their child die too soon. We pray for mothers who grieve because they're cut off from their children by disappointment, anger, or bitterness. We pray for mothers who are worried or afraid for their child's well-being and safety. We pray for those for whom the church does not feel like a safe place to be because they have been hurt by others. We pray for those for whom church is an uncomfortable place to be. And we pray, Lord, that you would bring healing, comfort, forgiveness, and peace into the hearts and minds of all who are hurting today. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray today, Lord, for children who grieve because they've lost their mother through illness, accident, or violence. We pray for children whose mothers have been unable to give them the love and care that they need. We pray for children who are still living in homes that are unsafe. And we pray for children who, through hardship and poverty, are not being provided with adequate medical care. We pray for those children who will flee because of the war today, for those that will find themselves homeless. We pray especially for the children of Ukraine. We ask you, Heavenly Father, to bring love and security, courage and hope into the lives of all children who hurt today. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We ask you, Heavenly Father, to bring healing and forgiveness into the lives of all those for whom today brings back painful memories of broken relationships and loss. Help us all to find in the brothers and sisters of Christ a loving family with whom we may show your love and tender care for all your hurting children. May we be a church that opens our arms and our doors to all of your beautiful children. And may we offer love unconditionally in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Loving God, we hold before you now those people who are on our hearts and minds today. In a moment of silence, we name them before you. We remember too before you those who grieve today, those unknown to us, who we see on our TV screens or read about in our newspapers, and those known to us, as we name them before you now. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Loving God, trusting in your promise to hear us when we pray in faith, we ask you to bless all our relationships in the families of our homes, our church, and our communities, so that through our lives, your loving will for us may be done. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Now we come to the time of the peace. Through the prophet Isaiah, God says, "As a mother comforts her child, so I will comfort you. The peace of the Lord be always with you and also with you." We're going to sing our next hymn now, which is "Bind Us Together, Lord." So now we come to our time of spiritual communion. And now we give you thanks, because you formed your church on the apostles to stand firm forever as a sign on earth of your infinite holiness and the living gospel for all to hear. Where can I go from your spirit, or where can I flee from your presence? If I ascend to heaven, you are there. If I make my bed in the grave, you are there also. If I take the wings of the morning and settle at the farthest limits of the sea, even there your hand shall lead me, and your right hand shall hold me fast. Jesus says, listen, I am standing at the door knocking. If you hear my voice and open the door, I will come in to you and eat with you, and you with me. Lord our God, you prepare a table before us, and although we cannot be present at your holy Eucharist, by your grace, open our hearts to receive the gift of your Son, the Word made flesh, who, on the night that he was betrayed, took bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way, after supper, he took the cup. He gave it to them, saying, drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in remembrance of me. So send your Holy Spirit upon us, that, though separated by distance, we may still, through faith, be partakers in the benefits of Christ's offering of his body and his blood. And this we ask through the same Jesus Christ, our Saviour. Amen. We pray together. Most merciful Lord, your love compels us to come in. Our hands were unclean. Our hearts were unprepared. We were not fit even to eat the crumbs from under your table. But you, Lord, are the God of our salvation, and you share your bread with sinners. So cleanse and feed us with the precious body and blood of your Son, that he may live in us and we in him, and that we with the whole company of Christ may sit and eat in your kingdom. Amen. So now we have a time of reflection where we present our own spiritual communion with God. This period of spiritual communion will conclude with the saying of the Lord's Prayer. So as God's children and heirs with Christ, we cry in the Spirit, Abba, Father. Let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. Remember, I am with you to the end of the age, says the Lord. And so we're going to have our notices, and following that, we'll have our final hymn, which is Tell Out My Soul, one that is most apt for this Mothering Sunday.
Welcome to our notices for this week, a week where the sun has been out and it has been warming us
and seeing the bulbs and the spring flowers come forth from the ground, and seeing the lambs in the fields, it's got a real air of springtime about the weather, which always makes us smile just that little bit more, doesn't it? As we move forward, we are, as you will see behind me, inviting you to experience Easter. And that begins this week, as this week we are running Experience Easter events at various venues for the various schools around our benefice. On Monday, we'll be at Rockwoodine Wood with Prisley Primary. On Tuesday, staying at Rockwoodine Wood with Red Hill. On Thursday, again at Rockwoodine Wood with Rockwoodine Wood Juniors. And then on Friday at Queenswood School. And the children will be invited to come and to go around different areas and experience the Easter story. So please do pray for those events and have a look in our newsletter for more information. Also, on our way to experience Easter, there is a choir practice at Holy Trinity Rockwoodine Wood at 7:30 this coming Thursday, which is in preparation for Choral Evensong, which will be one of our services during Holy Week, that run-up to experiencing Easter. During Holy Week, we will be running services every day. On Monday, there will be Stations of the Cross, in person or on site rather, 7 o'clock at Oaken Gates Church, Holy Trinity Oaken Gates, but also online. There will be an online service put out for that. On Tuesday, there will be an on site service, a healing service at St Peter's Priorsley. On Wednesday, another on-site service at Holy Trinity Rockwoodine Wood, which is the Choral Evensong. On Thursday, our on-site service is at 7 o'clock at Holy Trinity Oaken Gates, which is the Maundy-Thursday service with foot washing. But there will also be a live streamed service at 7 o'clock from Holy Trinity Rockwoodine Wood, which will be the stripping of the altar. On Friday, the on-site service will be at St Peter's at 2 p.m. as we spend an hour before the cross. But there will also be an ecumenical service online for Good Friday. Saturday at 4, we'll see Messy Church celebrating Easter, 4 o'clock at Rockwoodine Wood Church. And on Sunday, there will be an online service and several on-site services, an 8 a.m. BCP at Holy Trinity Rockwoodine Wood, 9:30 Holy Communion at Holy Trinity Oaken Gates, an 11 o'clock Holy Communion at Holy Trinity Rockwoodine Wood, and a 4 o'clock Holy Communion at St Peter's Priorsley. So we do hope that you'll be able to join us for many of those services, and that together we will experience Easter. This week there is a fashion show at Holy Trinity Oaken Gates on Tuesday at 7:30 if you wish to go along to that. And if not, then please do stay safe, and we look forward to worshipping with you all again soon. Please do continue to pray for those who are displaced across this world, for the people of Ukraine, and for those who grieve. This week being the families of Chris Roberts, Norman Riley, Linda Walker-Hill, Fred Smith, Anne Shaw, and Lawrence O'Connell. Be blessed. Have a great week. Bye-bye.
Thank you.
Well, I do hope you've enjoyed being with us for this service. And before we go, I'd like to just pray God's blessing upon you. So praise God who loves us. Praise God who cares. May God who gave birth to all creation bless us. May God who became incarnate by an earthly mother bless us. May God who broods as a mother over her children bless us. May Almighty God bless us, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. Go in the light and peace of Christ. Thanks be to God. Do take care. Stay safe.